So a horse walks into a bar, goes to order a drink, the barman looks at him and says, "Why the long face?" Oh shit, is this thing on? Ah, hello people. I am currently on my way to Moto Rapido Ducati in Winchester for something a little bit special. So I'm just making my way up to the dealers now, and this is not going to be a review of the bike that I'm taking out. This is going to be a reactions video, because I think I'm going to be gibbering like a loon or screaming like a little girl for the majority of the ride. So this is literally going to be a hold on for dear life and see what reactions we get type video. So I shall see you guys in a second. So as I say, this is going to be a reaction video. This is not going to be a review. Jesus Christ, already that seat is solid. Bloody hell, what am I doing on this? Compose yourself, man. It wants to go, it wants to go. I can't get over how loud it is. And she's already getting a bit warm. Right. Are we ready to deploy some Panigale power? Oh my god! Whoa! Keep that front wheel down, you naughty little fucker! That is fucking ridiculous! That quick shifter is fucking phenomenal! I can see why people need a quick shifter in their life. This is just savage. Jeez, easy. You literally just got to blink and you're gone. And that's barely at idle. That's just above idle. That noise is just so addictive. No clutch, just bang it down the gears. Oh, man. Seriously, I am not even getting halfway through the race, I don't think. But that is just so naughty. I'm holding on for dear life. What a machine. Oh my word. No clutch. How awesome is that? Fourth gear. And the front wheel's threatening to come up. But this just rides so beautifully. I've hardly noticed any bumps in the road at all. But what a bike, what an engine. Oh man, it's savage. That is the only word to describe it, savage. On the one hand, I need one of these in my life. On the other hand, I wouldn't have my license in the UK for more than 2 minutes. Honestly. I mean, she doesn't even come alive until about 7,000-8,000 RPMs. You drive, the engine revs like an inline four. I have no doubt that this bike would be utterly supreme in the corners, but oh my word, the talent required to push the envelope on this bike is just, it staggers belief how good and competent a rider you would have to be to actually be able to use this machine to anywhere near its potential. Clearly, I do not possess those skills at the moment, or I suspect will ever possess those skills. Basically, this test ride has come about because I made an inquiry, a genuine inquiry, I hasten to add, about trying to purchase one of the Anniversarios, which is based on the 1299S, but with even more upgraded electronics and limited edition and the gorgeous paint scheme. Basically, Ducati UK have taken about 70 deposits, bearing in mind they're going to be getting between 30 to 35 bikes, sort of figures I've heard bandied around. So I was too late for that boat, and basically Moto Rapido came back to me and said, but would you be interested in trying a 1299S? But I am utterly terrified of, well, I'm not terrified of this bike because actually it's not that bad to ride, it's fairly docile, but you can tell this bike is just desperate to be let off the leash. You know, perfect scenario if I had managed to get picked to get an Anniversario model. There is no way I could have ridden that bike anywhere near what it's capable of. But then given that it's a limited edition one, and I would literally only take it out to the odd bike night and for general, you know, days out on for, you know, something special, that would have fitted the bill. To have this as a road bike, bearing in mind I don't currently do many track days other than the odd Odium airfield day, this would literally just be a point and squirt machine and hold on for dear life and lose my license. It just goads you on. It's like, come on, don't be chicken. You've still got quarter of the throttle to go yet. But honestly, it's painful to try and keep yourself behind this thing and hold on for dear life. Brakes are pretty, I tell you what, this thing has got exceptional brakes, but it bloody well needs them. Holy shit, my mind is just totally scrambled by this. Here's the thing. Here's the rub. I would love this sort of power, this sort of bike performance spectacle event in my life. I would love something like this and just step up and be able to play with the big boys. But hey, I don't have the skills to tame this sort of power. B, you cannot ride a bike like this within its capabilities on the road. You will not have a license long, or you will end up in scenery. It's not because the bike is terrifying like maybe the 1199 is on the road, because the 1199, from what I've read, it's not a very nice road bike. That power could get very addictive very, very quickly. Personally, the reason why I absolutely adore the Panigale, however you say it, is because of the looks of the bike. I think that this is one of the most beautiful machines I have ever set my eyes on. See, she wants to go! You just can't have this much performance and expect to use any of it on the road. You'd have to take a bike like this to the track. Now, what sort of a masochist have you got to be to spend 20 or 1,000 pounds on a bike like this and purely use it as a, like, a track toy? You know, this is the difference of real world economics. If you could afford to risk devaluing and potentially binning a bike like this, and you have, oh, that noise! But to have a bike like this, take it to the track, to actually use it to its full potential, which a bike like this deserves to be used in a manner like that, you need huge testicles to actually be able to push the envelope, and you need to be prepared to overstep the limits, because you only find where the limits are by overstepping them and bringing it back, which means you risk binning a 20 odd thousand pound investment. That's a house deposit for most normal 200,000 pound houses for a UK resident. It just beggars belief that this sort of thing is legal. Honestly, what a machine. Right, I'm going to stop at Loomis, I'm going to put my eyes back in, I'm going to gather my thoughts, find where my testicles have gone. I shall see you guys in a tick. So there we go then. Now we're going to take this gorgeous machine back to Moto Rapido Ducati and say a huge thank you to them for letting me not only take it out for a test ride, but also kind of maybe taking it for a little bit longer than pre-arranged. What an absolutely stunning machine this is. But, oh baby, I need this sort of power in my life, but I don't need this much power. But yeah, I mean, that engine just dominates everything, and I'm pretty sure there's quite a few road tests that have said exactly the same thing. This engine's an absolute peach and it just dominates the whole bike in a good way, because they're using the electronics to really harness it and get the most out of it. But sadly, you do still need to be a fairly talented rider to exploit the electric. I mean, I've literally left this bike in sport mode. I haven't put it in race mode. I haven't put it in wet mode. I was shown how to do it, but I'm not even remotely interested in doing that at the moment. That is literally just a little squirt, and that is just ridiculous. Oh look, overtaking opportunity, gone. This actually doesn't feel like a big bike as well. I've been surprised by that. I've not really thought of that. I've not really mentioned that. This doesn't feel like a humongous bike. When I get on the scrambler, that feels absolutely tiny and properly lightweight. So I guess I shall say a huge, huge thank you to Moto Rapido Ducati in Winchester for allowing me to take this bike out for a test ride. And before I get onto the motorway and do the boring bit, I shall simply say thank you for watching this video. Farewell. Ma salama.